Quick thing before we start. I was sent the video, but there was already music on there. However, the original files appear to have been lost. But don't worry, I added subtitles and make the video as audible as possible. Alright, now on to the video.
What's going on, guys? My name is Freaky Jordan. Welcome back to this episode of Trap Tuesday on Chessmeal. Last week we did the England trap. This week we're doing the fishing pole trap. It's a knight sacrifice. It's out of the Roy Lopez opening. And as you can see by the board setup, and it is from Black's perspective. So as I said, pretty nice trap. I like it. And before we begin, make sure you subscribe to the channel on YouTube, follow us on Twitch, watch the videos, like, comment, subscribe, tell us what you like, tell us what you don't like, and let's get into it. So, as you can see, I flipped the board because it is from Black's perspective. Obviously, as I said, out of Roy Lopez, the standard e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6. You've seen this in a majority of your games if you ever played the king's pawn opening. I like playing the king's pawn. I don't like to do a lot of super fancy traps. And obviously, white goes bishop b5 for part of this trap. Black follows up knight f6, threatening the white pawn. Still defending this pawn technically, and white castles next. Black goes knight b4, not only defending this pawn in case it will take this way, but also threatening h2 and h3. Not really threatening much right now, but it is threatening it. And then the trap really starts as white pulls up h3. As I said at the beginning, it's a knight sacrifice, so you go h5, wanting white to take the knight there. White does because it's a free knight. And black goes by taking back on g4 with their pawn, opening up the h file and threatening knight at the same time, to where if white wants to not get checkmated, then they have to give up their own knight. But say they're greedy, knight e1, only to where the knight goes without being taken or threatened very soon. Because knight goes h2, you're in a pretty similar position. In fact, doesn't change anything. So knight goes e1, trap's already in place, mate in 4 by this point. Queen goes h4, as it is shown, threatening that mate. White's only move to keep the game alive, so f3. Black follows up with g3 instead of taking, because you don't need to take there. If you take there, you're actually just letting white escape, because take, knight's back out, you're threatening, boom, and your back end doesn't work for you at all. Or even queen take, king goes here, then just kind of running away from this point, and this knight actually doesn't do anything. It's just kind of a little move I just did, because obviously now rook just takes, and queen moves for checkmate, actually. So don't do that if you're black, don't take. Instead, as I said, push pawn, g3, now there's literally nothing white can do. Next turn's mate regardless. White takes, mate. White brings the knight out, mate, as in c, so that's the trap. So we'll go through it from the very beginning, naming all the moves. e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, bishop e5, knight f6, white king side castle, knight c4, h3, h5, pawn capture knight g4, pawn capture pawn g4, knight e1, queen h4, f3, g3, d4, just because it's an in-between move, because nothing matters by this point. And queen h2 or h1, doesn't matter, checkmate, that's the game. So, and then, I like the trap, it's nice, it's fun. A lot of things that white can do to kind of counter it early. But, that's the way it is, it's a 9-move trap. You need all 9 moves to go in your favor. So, if you guys enjoyed, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and tell us what you think. Like, what you don't like, what traps you want to see next, and I'll talk to you all later. Peace out.